back then, I'm an old school, like, you get that bop in your head, just like, when you locked in, or you just bop your head, and you just, nowadays, I mean, don't even, I like it, I ain't gonna hate on the young cats, but it's just a difference, you know what I'm saying?
Indeed, yes, indeed. You know what it is. It's Thursday, and we in the building, man. I go by the name Big Kev, and that's my DJ right there. What's your name, man?
Brooklyn Joker. What's good, y'all?
And you know we got a dope, dope show lined up for y'all today. We got some dope music. You know, I know it's a football game going on tonight. It's the Eagles and somebody, and I know we just had to first week of football, so you know, a lot of people is mad, a lot of people hype. You know, all the Jets fans is pissed off.
Mad is an understatement. If you a G-man, you mad is an understatement. If you a G-man,
you know, I'm not into football like I used to be, but you know, I like to watch good games. You know, but boy, where I work at, it was a lot of disappointed Pittsburgh fans, and the few people I didn't even, you know, I know the Jets got fans, but a couple of people
we kind of jealous of you then. You ain't no fan no more. You sparing yourself the heartbreak.
I mean, you know, I just like to watch, you know.
We all over here heartbroken.
You know,
this
I was
week.
A Peyton Manning and Michael Vick fan.
Yeah.
So, you know, I've only been to two college football games my whole life. The first college football game I went to a Tennessee game. My homeboy Tory Edge used to play for Tennessee. And I got to see Peyton Manning play. And I was like, yo, this white boy bad. Who is this? And from that moment, I followed him. And when he came to the NFL, my favorite player, I was a Colt fan. When they traded him to Denver, they traded me too. You know what I'm saying? I went right with him. You
know, I went to Denver too. Me too.
You know, I went right with Denver. You know what I'm saying? And I still root for Denver now because that was my, you know, my last team. But you know they ain't really hitting like.
Like you a fan of the big brother of my Eli? So,
you know what I'm saying? So you know, but you know I love Vic. You know what I'm saying? Everything that he did. You know, but I like his players. I like to watch. I like to watch Lamar Jackson. I like to watch Mahomes.
There's players I like to watch too, but yeah, I still, you know, got a team, sir.
Yeah, you know, but
I'm a Raiders fan.
You know, what's your team, sir?
I mean, you know, it's still the Broncos.
Wishy-washy. Okay.
You know, it's still the Broncos, okay. But I just don't get into football the way I used to. You know what I'm saying? I watch more Philly games because my brother is a Philly fan. And usually when I'm watching football, I'm watching it with him. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, he might switch back and forth to a different game. But I like to watch when two good teams play. But I'm more of a basketball fan. You know, I can watch basketball all day. As long as I got some smoke and something to drink, it ain't got to be no liquor. You know, it can be some juice, water. I ain't got to leave the crib. You know what I'm saying? I can watch basketball all day, man. But that's neither here nor there, man. We got a dope show lined up. We got a special guest in the building right now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We got a special guest in the building. He want to drop a few jewels on y'all. Let y'all know about a couple of things going on. We got my dog TJ in the building. TJ, what's happening,
welcome,
G? Nothing much, man. Just cooling, baby.
Welcome to Feed the Streets Radio. You
yes,
know
sir.
What I'm saying?
Yeah, man.
Now, TJ works with Congressman Bobby Scott, if I'm correct, right?
I do.
And they have an event going on this weekend, you know, Sunday, and it is the Lock It In Safety Supply for Success. And they are going to be giving away gun locks, and they are going to give away 100 stuff. Book bags with school supplies.
You heard.
So we gonna get into that and let TJ tell y'all everything that's going down.
Yep.
It is popping off this Sunday. You see what I'm saying? This Sunday it is going down, and I'm gonna let him tell y'all all about it. You know what I mean? And if you want a gun lock for your gun, cause you got kids running around, or you just need a gun lock anyway.
If you got kids that need school supplies,
yeah, you can come up here, get a free gun lock, and get a free book bag with supplies. You know what I'm saying? See what I'm saying? See all the stuff we be bringing to y'all for free, man. Ain't gonna cash at me $500. Show me you got some money, man. You know what I'm saying?
For y'all that have any questions, there's gonna be people there that can answer your questions.
Yes, indeed. They gonna show you about the gun locks, all that good stuff, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, come get a free book bag with stuff supplies. You know, I know the holidays is getting ready to come up. You know, everybody want PS5s and Jordans and LeBrons. You know what I'm saying? They're going to be running out of school supplies. Now you can get some stuff for free. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about? Come on, man. This is what we do every time for y'all, man.
Come on.
Like I said, go on Cash App, us $500. Show us you got some money, man. You know what I mean? Stop playing games.
Show us you got some money.
Nah, but what's good, TJ? How you feeling, man?
Man, I'm just cooler, man. Just sitting here and want to come and help you guys feed the streets, man.
Yeah, talk
about this event. But I appreciate y'all sharing the platform with me and y'all listeners, man. But I do work with Congressman Bobby Scott, but this event is actually with my nonprofit, Dean Ball Sports, Inc. And what we do, we typically we use sports as an outlet. Aberdeen Raiders, so we have basketball, football, baseball. But we also engage in stuff civically. Work with education, and more specifically, we stop violence and help prevent violence.
Are y'all based out of like an office or online?
We are based online. We have online platform on Facebook and stuff like that, but we do have sports programs. And we're based here in Hampton. But this particular event is where we partner with the city of Hampton Youth and Young Adult Opportunities Office. We also partner with Bass Pro Shops. We partner with Moms Demand Action. A lot of grassroots organizations to try to help reduce this gun violence. Like we was talking on stage, gun violence is not just about gang banging. One part of it. But, you know,
that's about all that falls in line with the dangers of having a weapon.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying?
Pro-gun and some are anti-gun, but if you pro-gun, there's still a way you're supposed to go about doing it.
Exactly.
And a lot of people are not aware.
Exactly. and these guns is dangerous, man. Like I own two of them, and it's not a Second Amendment debate. If you got a gun, that's cool, but if you got a gun, lock it up, store it safely.
That's what I'm saying. If you got a gun, and you're not doing what you're supposed to do as far as keeping it safe, then you're not being safe.
Exactly.
You're contributing to the problem.
Exactly. Yeah. You know, I got two grandkids, 8 and 7, and they're curious. They be roaming around the house, whatever, and if they stumble upon your gun and they find it, they're curious. They're kids, you know, and something accidentally happened, or they take it to school and show it to their classmates and stuff. You know, do they know how to respond in that situation? Do they know how to act if my friends bring a gun to school? So this event is going to teach and promote safety and promote safe handling of firearms, because we can't act like it's taboo and not talk about it. Guns are here, bro.
Yes, indeed.
Like, we got more guns than we do people.
Right.
So it's all about just to those adults who have guns, just be more aware and cognizant of your surroundings and store it safely. So we're going to have a bounce house. We're going to have free book bags. We're going to have free ice cream for the kids.
Oh, man, I'm coming to get some ice cream.
Man, pull up. It's going. You know how Virginia weather is. You know, it's still going to be hot.
Like ice cream.
So ice cream is always time for ice cream, man. We're going to have Dream Chaser Auto Club. They pulling up with their cars. We're going to have a bike club pulling up. So the event is for everybody, six and adults.
And where it's going to be at?
It's going to be at Aberdeen Elementary School, 1424 Aberdeen Road in Hampton, Virginia, man. Pull up on us Sunday.
That's Sunday.
Sunday.
September 17th.
Yes, sir.
1 p.m. to 5 p.m. Because, listen, if you don't go get your free gun lock, you're going to have to buy one from me. 200. You know what I'm saying? 250.
Raising,
you don't get it. Why the goodness good? You know what I'm saying?
I do want to add, though, we also giving away a gun safe, and we giving away a gun cabinet. So if you got them long range guns, them shotguns, them ARs, now you're or whatever.
Talking about with a brother here,
you know what I'm saying? If you got a few guns,
I don't need that.
Exactly.
I don't need no locks, but
so
let me ask
you something. How did you get involved with all of this? Like, how did you go? You know what I'm saying? How was you put to, you know, make all of this happen? Like, you know, is it because you was working with the city, or these were things that you were already, you know, putting into fruition? You just needed the right people to help you get them going.
It came about because I've always been like a advocate of social justice. My background has always been mental health, human services, working with the kids. So I've always been an advocate of social justice, and just seeing what I can do to be a part of my community. Like, people can talk about the problem all the time, but we need more solutions, more doers. So I'll just say, what can I do to help? Is it going to solve all of the gun violence issues? No. But what can I do as a citizen to get involved and help? So I was like, more recently, with the Newport News incident, with the Richnet situation,
yeah.
I'm pretty sure you heard about the six-year-old took their parents' firearm.
Yeah, I was talking about that on my show last week because I was upset with her. I was upset with her, not for the situation because things happen, but I was upset with her because I'm like, you know, these people got their nose all in your business. Why you ain't keeping it the way you supposed to?
Yeah,
you
she went and got herself into more trouble
on top of the trouble. You know, what you do, I don't judge nobody. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Do what you do, what you like to do.
Right.
But one thing I do tell people, if you doing you the way you like to do you, but you got the wrong people with their nose in your business, and you know that it's going to jeopardize everything you got going on, then you need to stop doing you the way you do you. You know what I'm saying? Until this is over with. You know what I'm saying?
You're not in the position to do you like you want
to
do you.
Because, you know, she make young black mothers look bad. You know what I'm saying? And when I was growing up, you couldn't even talk about somebody's mama. You know, if you say something about somebody's mama, guess what? When we, it might go down on the school bus. But when you get off the school bus, be ready to fight. This is the first time in my life that I see so many young kids that don't even really like their mamas. Like, you talk to some of these young boys and young girls, they'd be like, I can't stand my mama. You know, or they'll be like, you know, man, my mama, man, she just
doing too much. Took that whip away.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Because we was beaten to respecting our mama and loving our mama. You know, you better.
Go get that belt.
And it's like, you know, I feel like a lot of these newer parents, the whole I'm my child's friend. That's cool.
I'm not against that.
Yeah, that's cool.
But where's the stern part?
Yeah,
though?
You can't
where's
be the
firm,
friend so much that the child
where's the,
keep doing
where's the board stuff? Part that yeah. where he fall, he hit the board and be like, whoa, right. Where that part at?
You know, I don't have kids, but I've dated chicks with kids. I got guard kids, you know what I'm saying? I got plenty of nieces and nephews, and I laugh and joke with them all day long. But they know if they get out of line, they know Uncle Kev don't play. You know what I'm saying? They know if I raise my voice, they know. Oh, stop playing, Uncle Kev getting serious. You know what I'm saying? You know all this. Oh, my child can say what they want and express themselves. Yo, he's 6, 7, 8 years old. You're not telling me what to do. And I see that happen with a lot of parents. And I felt like in her situation, after she's been put all over the news, and you know, she has this nonchalant attitude. Now you get caught with cocaine and weed in your system. Now they getting ready to, you could lose your child.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And some more stuff, like, come on now. You know, you can learn a lot from a dummy. I'm going to have to put that back on a t-shirt. You can learn a lot from a dummy. Because people be doing the craziest stuff. You know what I'm saying? And I just felt like in her situation, with everything that's going on with her son, she not supposed to be... them people all over you. You know what I'm saying? They're all over you. So you supposed to be walking a straight arrow and until all this is over with.
Right, right.
You know what I mean? Because now every little move you make that you do, they're going to be on you and they're going to put it on the news.
In all honesty, I ain't no psychologist, but, you know, when when you make a mistake, if it's really a mistake, your behavior would show that.
Yeah.
And her behavior is not showing that,
right? You know what I'm saying?
It really don't take a psychologist, is what I'm saying, to see that. Like, your behavior not showing that you're remorseful for what took place. Mm-hmm. And that's gonna be held against you in court.
Yeah, you're right.
Even more reason why you're supposed to tighten up.
So let me ask you something, TJ. Now I know y'all doing the gun locks and all that stuff. Do you know anything about having felons get their gun license back? Do you know anything about that genre of things?
No, I don't know about anything like that. That may come later down the road, but because I know they're still working an uphill battle when it comes to just restoring voting rights.
Yeah. I just got mine back last year.
Right.
You know what
last
I'm saying?
Election.
Yeah. Right. And shifting gears a little bit, you know, the current administration, they're making it difficult now for felons to get their rights back, because when you release under the previous administration, Governor, I think McAuliffe, but the previous administration, as soon as you get released, your rights and stuff are automatically restored.
Yeah.
But now under Youngkin, when you release, it's a lot of barriers and roadblocks that they put in place to make it harder. So to your question, getting rights to bear arms and stuff and get guns and stuff, that's another conversation. That's gonna be later down the road. I ain't gonna sit here and lie to you.
I was just wondering since you know you was dealing with the whole, you know, stop the violence. I was just wondering if you know was tied into that part of the game as well.
I kind of had to do my own educating of my kids with that when it comes to that part.
Mm-hmm.
Both of my sons, 21 and 19, both of them chose that they was gonna carry. So I was like, man, I gotta stay on them then. Do it the right way.
And that's the thing. This is not about a Second Amendment. Like I said, I got two guns. Hey, have at it. But I just want to put the ownership and responsibility on us, quote unquote, adults.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? If you're going to have your guns or whatever, just store it safely, man.
He's safe.
Like, that's you ain't got to leave your burner on the table locked and ready to go. Like, nah, man, you got kids around.
Yeah.
You know, just because we get this movie mentality that somebody going to run up in our house and we just got to. You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna say it don't happen, but when you look at the bigger picture, what's the likelihood of someone running up in your house while you're home, and you got to get your joint off the nightstand to use it? So, with that being said, like, you can store it safely. You can store it without it being loaded. Like, if someone's gonna break into your house, they're gonna break into your house when you're not home. You know what I'm saying? So, I just want to put the ownership on us adults to be more safe when it comes to these firearms, because it's not a game.
You're all gonna have it.
Like, there's no reset button. A lot of kids get this, they become desensitized to Grand Theft Auto, to video games, social media, whatever, and they think it's a game. But you shoot somebody, it's no reset button. It's no do-over.
It's real.
Like, so, you know what I'm saying? I just want to bring awareness to that. And with this, we're gonna be passing out free gun locks, free gun safes, free gun cabinets. We're just gonna be promoting safe storage, and that's the whole idea for that day. So, man, come out September 17th on a Sunday from 1 to 5. You still got time to check out football.
Yeah, you hear
that? You know
what
I'm saying? I know it's football Sunday and all, but you still got time to check out your games. You got your phones, your devices. Pull up on us, man. Yeah. Social support. One more thing I want to add.
Go ahead.
The Hampton Sheriff Department, they're gonna be donating 2 bulletproof book bags. Man, I ain't never seen bulletproof book bags before, but
see if I can get one of those.
Like, yeah, it's like a good thing and a bad thing, though. It's like good thing, like, damn,
I'm trying to get one of them too.
Yeah, but at the same time, it's like, yo, we at that point, we need bulletproof book bags now.
Yeah.
So it's a whole shift. It makes you think where we going to in this society, man.
They
but
definitely was promoting the see-through book bag.
Yeah.
They are. You know, they're trying their best to make everybody safe. But yeah, we're gonna be giving away bulletproof book bags, gun vaults, gun cabinets. Superior Pawn Shop, they giving away 1 year.
My first gun.
Hey, on Berkeley Boulevard, exactly. They coming through.
Went to my first reins.
Exactly.
My first gun with Superior Pawn.
They partnering with us, and they're going to give away 1 year free gun range pass.
Oh, man, I'm missing out on all the good
stuff.
I'm coming.
Come up, pull up, man. You know what I'm saying?
All the good stuff. I need to get in the gun range, man. You know, I gotta go to somebody's backyard in the country and shoot. You know what I'm saying?
No collide in the sticks. You know what I'm saying? So
no,
yeah.
Not necessarily. You can go to the range. I could go to the range too.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, we could go to the range. We just can't buy nothing. But you can go to the range.
What I'm saying? So yeah, so pull up on us, man.
It's going down. Sunday, September the 17th. Locking in safety supply for success.
Yeah, man.
They are giving away free gun locks. They are giving away gun safes. They are giving away some free bulletproof book bag. They might not be available because I'm going to get one of those. You know what I'm saying?
I'm getting
you
up.
Know, they got 100 stuffed book bags with all type of school supply. Ain't no candy in there. Just school supplies, you know what I'm saying? You always, you know that he's always a kid in school. You got a pen, yo. You got
exactly.
A pen.
Hey, semester, you
send your son
some.
And your daughter Let's up go. Here to get some free school supplies, and they're going to be schooling y'all about gun safety awareness. It's going to be food trucks out there. They're going to have a DJ out there. Aberdeen Elementary School.
On Sunday.
A lot of y'all's kids go to there. Yep. You know what I'm saying? It is going down 1 to 5 Sunday, September the 17th. Let everybody know. They got free ice cream. Now, you know, I'm going to go up there and get me some ice cream.
I'm about to say, I'm coming.
You know what
they
I'm
got
saying?
Too much. They got too much of my favorite price. My favorite price when I go out is free 99.
You know what I'm saying? Because every time I leave the crib, I got to spend some money. I don't get to do nothing for free.
When you they say free, I'm there.
So 1 to 5 this Sunday, it is going down. Gun safety awareness is the locking in safety supply for success. Stop the violence. It's too much gun violence going on. Too many young kids getting murdered and too many throwing their life away. And women are getting murdered at a high rate right now, getting shot.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Getting shot. And I ain't telling no jokes. This for real.
A lot of domestic violence situations.
You seeing every day on the news, I see a woman got murdered, kidnapped, something. You know what I'm saying? Hey, listen, this is where you need to be Sunday. 1 to 5. Come holler at TJ. You know what I'm saying? You heard what he just said. They get free gun locks. You know how much a gun lock costs in the store? Do you? Or have you thought about it? Yeah, you need one. You know your son half crazy. You know, you got to put him on his medication. He get to acting crazy. You know what I'm saying? You need a gun lock on your stuff, man. You know what I mean? It is going down Sunday, 1 to 5. They giving out free book bags, stuff with supplies, 100 of them. They giving out free bulletproof book bags.
Yep.
There's only a couple. They might, like I told, they might be gone. I'm going to try to pull some strings to get me one of those, you know, just to be like, you ain't up on this. You know what I'm saying? And they giving out gun safes. I mean, hey, it ain't too many places you can go where everything is free. You know, come out there, learn gun safety awareness, because in these days and times, you ain't got to run around with your pistol, but it's good to have something in the house to protect the fort, you know? Tell them, hey, you might get me over there, but if you come right here, hey, somebody in trouble, you know what
That's
I'm saying? It's going down, you know? So y'all need to come out, holler at TJ, you know what I'm saying? It's going to be a good event, great knowledge for you to learn, for you to pick up on some things. If you don't know how to work gun locks and things of that nature, there will be people there to show you what is going down, you know what I'm saying?
Or if you don't even know how to have that conversation with your child, you know what I'm saying? They're out there to show you to have that conversation with your child. If they see a loaded firearm, what do you do? If your friend shows you a gun in school, what do you do? So, yeah, man, it's all positive energy, man. And it's not, we're not against guns. We just want you to be safe with guns.
All about spreading safety awareness, man. So we want y'all to come out. I'm going to remind y'all again before the show go off, because I know how your memory get, you know what I'm saying? Get real short, you'll forget all about it, you know what I'm saying? But if you want to be a part of this, come on out Sunday from 1 to 5, Aberdeen Elementary School. It is going down. Dean Ball and Sports Incorporated, baby.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Sponsored by them. I'm going to have to hit somebody up and be like, look, man, tell them that the bulletproof book bags
got ours.
You know what I'm saying? They got lost. You know, we don't know what happened to them. You know what I'm saying?
You got to be the y'all first one with those.
The show started.
Yeah, I appreciate you coming through, G.
Feed the Streets Radio.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I appreciate you coming through. Shout out everybody on the live. Barbara, what's happening? Son of Sam, Candy Cane, Al Burner, what's happening? You know what I'm saying? What's going down? We getting ready to get this thing started. You know, we had a special guest in the building. Y'all know how we do. So we wanted to keep it respectful. We ain't want to. We ain't want him to have to go out of here smelling like Cheech Chong. You know what I'm saying? And we getting ready to get this thing started. Don't forget, it's going down Sunday, 1-5, September 17th, Aberdeen Elementary School. You know what I'm saying? Come get your free gun locks. Come get your kids some free school supplies and book bags. You know, I still got a book bag in the back of my car with some stuff in it. You know what I'm saying? I might let them have that. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? And come get you some free ice cream. Come learn about gun awareness. You know what I'm saying? And guess what? You might see me. You might not. If they tell me I can get one of them bulletproof book bags, you're going to see me, though. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we get ready to get this thing started. We get ready to set the show off. You know, we wanted to get the interview out the way so we can hit y'all with this heat that we about to hit y'all with that we do every Thursday. You know what I'm saying? You know who the number one 19 radio is? Feed the Streets, baby. You know what I'm saying? We going to set this thing off with that boy Jetta representing Brooklyn / ATL. You know what I mean? He resides out of Brooklyn, but he live in Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? And this joint called Warning, and you already know where you heard it first. Feed the Streets Radio, powered by Virginia. Bang, bang, let's go.
You know she pressure. I swear to God, these rabbits do the most. Talking all that shit, but be crying to them folks. I try to warn niggas that I'm pressure. This bitch I'm fucking with, you know she pressure. I swear to God, these rabbits do the most. Talking all that shit, but be crying to them folks. Tell bartender, break a couple bottles. She a IG model, but she still gon' swallow. Niggas stutter when it's pressure, call on YG. Couple 38s on me, call on Siamese. Shorty spent the rent money, got an ass right. The head good, I was fucking with her last night. Bitch, you know who the fake and who the real is. Been getting money, just ask about me, I'm still is. Niggas acting like they want it, then they pump fake. Document boys, they talking to them blue jicks. And I don't fuck with nobody if it's bad vibes. TLC shit, I shoot them in his left eye. We getting money, all my niggas got a bag too. Skinny nigga, but my pockets feel like Shamu. Smack shorty on the ass, get a head straight. Bunch of broke ass niggas, call them dead weight. I try to warn niggas that I'm pressure. This bitch I'm fucking with, you know she pressure. I swear to God, these rabbits do the most. Talking all that shit, but be crying to them folks. I try to warn niggas that I'm pressure. This bitch I'm fucking with, you know she pressure. I swear to God, these rabbits do the most. Talking all that shit, but be crying to them folks. My attitude and my mind state is different too. Touch any one of my niggas and we gon' make the news. We getting money, feed the fam, that's what we on. My cousin fresh out of prison, got some G's for him. These rap niggas scary, I'ma bring the pressure to him. Sending money in the air like it's West of Yen. Fitted hat with my own gear with some Tim's on. Stop fronting BU, that's some gems for him. That 40 cal to pluck a mind, talking rap and dope. Sure they wanna have some fun, I'm the after show. A white kid, some white ones, and I'm good. Think the jet are falling off, I wish I would. I try to warn niggas that I'm pressure. This bitch I'm fucking with, you know she pressure. I swear to God, these rabbits do the most. Talking all that shit, but be crying to them folks. I try to warn niggas that I'm pressure. This bitch I'm fucking with, you know she pressure. I swear to God, these rabbits do the most. Talking all that shit, but be crying to them folks. Yeah, it's a warning shot, man. We bringing pressure to these niggas, man. It's not a game. Y'all niggas better wake up. Yeah. I try to warn niggas that I'm pressure. This bitch I'm fucking with, you know she pressure. God, these rabbits do the most. Talking all that shit, but be crying to them folks. I try to warn niggas that I'm precious. I mean, this bitch I'm fucking with, you know she precious.
If I got on here and lied to you, I feel like I'm part of the problem. But when I tell the truth, it's a bigger problem. Which to me sums up the whole problem. But at the end of the day, somebody gotta say it, man. Yeah. Yeah. I need room, I need peace, I need space right now. See me run into a bag, I'm out of shape right now. I've been lost the whole time, I find my way somehow. And you know they say what goes up must come down. That's why I'm living in the moment, I need peace right now. Vegan shorty, I don't want no beef right now, no. Maybe when I finish doing me, we can eat. I keep having dreams of falling off and I'm sleep. That's why I stay up getting to it, cause nobody do it. I had to slow down, showing love, that mean I chopped and screwed it. It really shut down my system, I had to reboot it. Don't do no acting, I'm a star, nigga, my life a movie. I'm about that cash money, I feel like I'm Juvie. And I've been sitting on this plan, just need to execute it. I'm a chameleon with this music, it's just evolution. It hit the airway with that bullshit, it's just more pollution. All I hear is problems on top of problems with no solution. All I see is women shaking asses, we attract pollution. All I hear is people in their feelings about the fucking system. See some niggas stick to what they know and not what they be wishing. They never like this, never will, so I don't look forward to it. They got the fire already lit, I just don't bring more to it. We gotta have that conversation and we want elevation. Sometimes the truth can get you killed, so I be trying to say it. No, no, no. Hey, we at war with ourselves and our hearts, but we still ain't one. Hey, and I know time show the strength in the numbers, but we still ain't one. Hey, I see my people giving up, gotta keep fighting, though we still ain't one. Yeah, and I've been waiting for my God to come and save us, but he still ain't
when one. When I lay down, keep my head high. When police kill a nigga, I am not surprised. Not only competition, we the opposition. Everything we are, they wanna be, that's why they gotta steal it. But by the time we realize, we all gonna be stuck in prison. Free the ones that's locked up in that jail and locked up in that bitch. Apologize to anyone offended when I share my vision. I'm just fitting, looking through these melanated lenses. We make everything okay when it ain't. We justify the devil's work by making niggas saints. We live our lives depending, we don't take our time and think. They got us taking medicine and pouring in our drinks. And we don't know depression can be cured by what we eat. What's the price of being black when we gon' sell our souls for cheap? You don't have to be a lion in a room full of sheep. Cause if we move as a herd, nigga, everybody eat.
Say nothing about it. I just be laughing and get to the money. Count up the money, I'm counting. Stacking this shit till it turn to a mountain. Niggas be saying they real, but I doubt it. Pockets poking out like they was pouting. I don't want the Bentley, I just want the Audi. Niggas be talking and niggas be gossiping. I don't say nothing about it. I just be laughing and get to the money. Count up the money, I'm counting. Stacking this shit till it turn to a mountain. Niggas be saying they real, but I doubt it. Pockets poking out like they was pouting. I don't want the Bentley, I just want the Audi. Kept it quiet, they had me surrounded. Never been scared, but my heart steady pounding. They say I done lost it, but look how I found it. Still in the hood and I don't need a voucher. I was down bad, I was sleeping on couches. Now when I'm sleep, put my money in couch. Addicted to flipping, I love touching ounces. Check in my pocket, you just get allowance. Ran on your block, I ain't talking about showers. We all in the dirt, I ain't talking about flowers. You know I'm coming, ain't gotta reroute it. Bought him a fitted, cause he was a capper. I need the block, cause I am a trap. In front of my team, like my jersey on backwards. You can come see me, I'm the main attraction. This ain't no regular gas, I can't pass it. Just want the bread with the cheese like a sandwich. Fly as a plane and I cannot land it. I got the clip for the movies he act. They thinking I'm mad but I'm really relaxing. Still in the gutter, can't never turn savage. Stay with a gun in my bag, I got baggage. I just be speaking real shit, I ain't rapping. I ain't rapping. Niggas be talking and niggas be gossiping. I don't say nothing about it. I just be laughing and get to the money. Count up the money, I'm counting. Stacking this shit till it turn to a mountain. Niggas be saying they real, but I doubt it. Pockets poking out like they was pouting. I don't want the Bentley, I just want the Audi. Niggas be talking, they niggas be gossiping. I don't say nothing about it. I just be laughing and get to the money.
Count up the money, I'm counting. Stacking this shit till it turn to a mountain. Niggas be saying they real, but I doubt it. Pockets poking out like they was pouting. I don't want the Bentley, I just want the Audi. Bitch. Little bitch. Hey, let's go.
Yeah. You already know what it is. You know what I'm saying? It's Feed the Streets, man. And we set it off with that Jetta Warning. Then we hit y'all with that Rick Rogers Melanated Lenses. And then we hit you with that Yachty Breeze. Say less. Shout out everybody on the line. Nicole, what's happening? Loose Cannon, SOG Gang, what's happening? Everybody on the line, what it is, man. You know what I'm saying? That was a way to start the show off, G3 Bangers. So, there's a lot going on in news and hip-hop, and we're going to get right to it. You know what I'm saying? So, you know Wendy Williams, the talk show host. Y'all know she was going through a whole lot of stuff. She was sick. You know, her health was all messed up, and the people had, like, froze her money, and she was going through all these things. And, you know, her ex-husband had divorced her, and she had to get him a whole bunch of bread. Well, he didn't mess the bread up. And now he is trying to sue her for $10 million because he said he helped create the Wendy Williams show. And, you know, I was first, you know, I was happy because, you know, you see all of these guys that make millions of dollars and they have a child by the wrong person. And then they got to give these chicks $100,000, $80,000, $250,000 a month. And I'd be like, yo, that's out of control. You know what I'm saying?
But the shoe is on the other foot. Yeah, you know,
because, you know, all the women was mad that Mary J had to pay 30. She got to pay 30 grand a month to her ex-husband. You know what I'm saying? And I rock with Mary J all day. But I'm like, shoe, hey, sometimes the dudes got to win, too. But in this situation, I think dude is doing, like, way too much. Like, you know what she just went through, her health, her financial status, how they was playing with her paper. Now here you come because you didn't blew a couple of M's trying to live a lifestyle way beyond your means. So, you know, we're going to see what happened with that.
I ain't on his side.
Yeah, I ain't on his side either. I thought that was a clown move because I'm like, come on, dog. You just had a few
bro,
M's.
Bro, cheating with Superhead is like so old and so raggedy, like, like bro, like I would have respected a better cheat.
You know what I'm saying?
It's the cheat part that, it's not the cheat part. It's the who you cheat. That's the crazy part for me.
You know what
you
I mean?
Went there with it on Mary, you dummy. Nah, don't get that nigga no money. No nope.
30K, nigga, nope. You tripping?
Don't get that nigga
so,
no money.
So Ghana sells out the Barclays Center. And he had a thing up saying Free Young Thug. And the YSL Twitter page showed Gunna love. You know, now they say that somebody else behind the scenes is working the page. But at the end of the day,
Still haven't heard from
Gunna was the breadwinner over there at YSL. Outside of Young Thug, you know what I'm saying? But he did better numbers than Young Thug. So he was the breadwinner. So, you know, it's good that, you know, he's selling out shows and his album is moving. But he sold out of New York. You know?
He made us look bad on social media. I'm from Brooklyn. And last time I checked, the Barclays is in Brooklyn. So if you sell out the Barclays in Brooklyn, everybody said it must have had a lot of cheese in there. I see, man. I can't stand y'all social media motherfuckers, man. I can't stand y'all.
So, Young Blue.
I can't stand y'all.
You know him and Boosie been going at it. And now Young Blue has been caught up. He canceled his tour. See, I don't be understanding these things. I ain't canceling me going to go get these millions because I'm beefing with my girlfriend or my wifey.
Oh, hell no.
You know, I'm going to tell her, well, if you leaving, go and leave. Or if you want to roll with me while I'm on the road, come on. But I ain't missing these millions.
Hold on. You mean to tell me he still was actually selling tickets?
Yeah, he...
Oh, he supposed to take advantage of that. He on his way out the door.
He canceled his tour.
You're on your way out the door. You don't cancel
because
nothing.
Because he had the private... He had a private jet go pick up some random that he was trying to smash. First of all, you sent a private jet to go pick up a random.
Boy, that's about $4,000 and better. I know what private jets.
Wow.
Okay, you can't even get one for less than that.
Man, you could have put her on a first a round trip regular ticket. But, you know, hey, he got money like that. So he did that. And, you know, chicks love social media.
Last time
so
I
she
did.
Went on social media like, yeah, Young Blue flew me out in a private jet. But Young Blue is married. So his wife then found out about it, and I guess Boosie then put it out there that he was smashing like 20, 30 chicks or something crazy. So now the wife wanted a divorce, and he canceled his tour, talking about I'm trying to put my family back together. Man, you better go get that money. So
the one thing that's that's gonna help you when they fall apart.
He said what?
You know what I'm saying?
It's over. It's over. Get back to the bag.
You know, it's like he falling apart.
Let me tell you something.
I could be married and
only
got three
thing
gonna four
save
kids.
You is the bag.
If I did something wrong, I'm gonna have to pay for it. But you know what I'm not gonna do?
What's that?
I ain't missing
no
the millions.
Sure. I ain't canceling shit.
I tell her, okay, you mad at me? You can holler at me when I get back.
I have
can,
even more
we
reason
can get
to
this
go.
Straight. If you ain't trying to roll with me, if she say, well, I'm going to be gone when you get back, you know what I'm going to tell her? Well, just make sure the crib clean before you leave, because I'm going to get these millions.
I'm desperate. You know? If you can't wait till I get back to discuss this situation, then you're right. It is over.
I mean, if you think about it.
It is over.
Young
right.
Blue hasn't had no new music in a while.
He ain't had no new music when he had new music.
He had like three straight records that blew, and then, you know.
Hurry back up.
Drake. You know, got on his record and it took it through the roof, and
that's the only reason why y'all know about him.
And then you know he was selling out everywhere, but you know sometimes when people get money,
they
just start doing too much, and when you are getting the type of he was getting what 50,000 a show, man, listen,
50,000,
yeah. My girlfriend, wife, whoever it could be, she just gonna have to be pissed off. You know, I tell her, well, FaceTime me because I got to go.
Like
you
I said, if she can't hold off on the breakup until this, she can't hold off on the breakup until the money is made, then she is correct. We are broken up.
My thing is this. If he sent a private jet to go get some random, you want to put a smile on your wife's face, get her a Louis bag, fill it up with money. Tell her, I'm sorry. And you know what she going to say? Okay, baby. She gonna bitch a little bit. You know, you're going to have to hear about it for about 23 years. But, you know.
All I'm saying is.
She ain't going to take
whatever,
you to the bank and try to take
whatever,
all your money.
Whatever plea you plea, if you plea or not. The one thing you cannot do is not get the money, my dude. Mm-hmm. If you're going to get the girl back, cool. If you ain't going to get the girl back, cool. But you ain't going to get the money, not cool.
Yeah, you don't leave the money on the table, G. So,
Diddy performed, you see the math here?
Diddy performed at the VMAs, and a lot of people were wondering why Mace wasn't performing. He brought his son out to do Mace's verses. And people are saying that he, you know, he messed up so many relationships with people that now niggas is like, nah, I ain't going up there, man. I ain't
this means his career is almost gone.
You know, everybody
go
giving
get that
him
tour
his
money.
Like,
now.
If it wasn't for his son, last year his son had the song with Kodak Black. It went number one on the charts. If it that was the
Who
first
was his
number,
son?
Number just. What is it? Justin Combs? Yeah, he looked just like Diddy.
Oh.
That was the first number one song that Bad Boy Records had in a minute. You know what I'm saying?
And he got the video.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So, nobody was there. It wasn't like the BET joint where everybody came out. You know, so, you know, it's almost like dudes is like, man, I ain't rocking with you, did it, because you, you know, you took all my money. You know what I'm saying? You a billionaire. I'm out here scrambling. Sold 10 million records. Ain't got 50,000. You know what I'm saying?
While he was out getting y'all for y'all bread, somebody was in his house getting his girlfriend.
So Rick Ross, everybody was wondering why he was going on this spending spree. Well, he has secretly sold his catalog, and he did not want the terms to be, you know, disclosed and put out, so they have kept it kind of hush-hush. But he sold it. Everybody's selling the catalog.
Which is good if you don't want to harm the sales of the catalog.
Yeah.
Like, you wanted to still make money. That means they gave you a good piece of money, and in the junk, they was like, look, we just gonna keep this on the hush hush, because we want the sales to continue as such. Yeah. Sometimes when you say so-and-so own it, things change around.
Yeah, you're right, you're right.
So they might have learned from the last few joints that now we can't do it that way no more. So, coming out and saying so-and-so sold their catalog is making the catalog worthless. So now they can't even announce it no more. It's in the contract.
So Birdman says he is ready to put up $100 million for the Hot Boy reunion tour. But he says, I don't know if Turk going to be involved. Now, he say he don't got no problems with Turk, but he said that he wasn't as tight with Turk as he was with the rest of them. And, you know, I mean, that's cool, but my personal opinion, you can't have a Hot Boy reunion tour without Turk. No, he didn't have the solo success that BG, Wayne, and Juvie had. But with the Hot Boys, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, I blame Turk for this, you know, because Turk went on Drink Champs and got drunk. And he,
you don't bite the hand that
feeds. He started running his mouth. You know, I'm a big believer in this. Me and you been friends for a long time. Mm-hmm. We committed a crime together, right? But we have a fallout. We don't speak to each other no more. I ain't going on no shows telling dirt on you. I might not ever want to speak to you again for the rest of my life. But I ain't doing no TV interviews. Like, yo, let me tell you about Brooklyn Joker for real. You
the
know,
last
like,
thing I would want to do is talk about you during my interview.
Like to me, I don't
if,
get into
if
that.
If we not cool. You understand
you know what I'm saying?
Like, if I'm not cool with a person, the last thing I want during the interview is for you to ask me about the person I'm not cool with.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not going to go up here and start saying things that people don't need to know. People are real big right now on telling your business the motherfuckers that it ain't supposed to matter to. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not big on that. You know what I'm saying? I could have a fallout with you and not tell nobody about it. And if somebody say, yo, well, I never see you with such and such, oh, we don't really rock no more. You know, I ain't going to go into detail about it because it ain't none of your motherfucking business. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, it'd be too much of that. And he said, I think, something similar to the fact that every time Baby went to Universal to get a check, he would bring them back watches and shit instead of giving them money. And he was saying the Rolexes wasn't real and Baby ain't a real dude. And that might be true. That might be true.
But that's considered breaking one of the 48 laws.
Baby might not be real, you know.
Because
he did rob all of them. But this is my thing.
But you can't bite the hand that feeds you, bro.
You can't talk bad about him and then expect him to break bread with you.
Exactly.
Like, you know, and it's a lot of that going on in the world. People will talk trash about you, throw your, air your dirty laundry out, then be like, I'm saying you ain't put me down with the money game. Like, I should pistol whip you. Like, what is you talking about? You know what I'm saying? Like, put you down with the money game. You lucky I ain't put you down with the get stumped out game. You know what I'm saying? Like, what is you talking about? Like, you know, and Young Buck is feeling it right now. Young Buck is everybody know he having all these financial struggles. he wish that he could be a part of that final lap tour. Because Tony Yayo and Uncle Murder, they about to make like $2 million a piece just off the tour. And they just doing maybe one song of theirs, but they bagging 50 up the whole show.
They about to make more money off of this than they would have made if they did an album. If they did an album, they would have had to wait for the bread they making off this tour.
And they doing 95 cities. 95 cities, dog. That's a lot of shows. You know what I'm saying?
Is Banks up there?
Nope, because 50 and Banks don't rock. And, you know, I don't know Banks' financial situation, but, hey, I don't care how much money you got. $2 million is $2 million. You know what I'm saying?
I don't think it's... You can't hang with a person that don't want to hang with you, though.
Yeah, you're right. Well, you know, 50 said that Banks made a statement. Banks is not wasn't big on social media. So 50 tried to tell him that he needed to be active. So he said, Banks said, Big wouldn't have been active on social media like that. Pac wouldn't have been active. So he told him, he said, the shit didn't exist then. You know what I'm saying? And he was like, you have a big fan base, but you're not active on social media. You need to be. And he said, Banks was like, that's corny. So 50 said he knew from that moment he could never do business with Banks again. Now, you know, and Banks had retired from rap and everything. But he made a little comeback. He done dropped 2 albums, you know what I'm saying? And they doing good independently. No, they haven't had the success that he had with G-Unit where he was going platinum and all that. But independently, he did very well. Yeah. And he did, you know, small tours, 15 cities, you know, stuff like that. But he's rocking with
crowd,
Griselda
the crowd, though. The crowd where the money is younger people who don't really know who you are that well. So showing your face on social media, Banks, helps you promote you better in this new day and time.
Well, I think he learned that later on. Your favorite artist. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's my nigga.
You know, I think he learned that later on because I follow Banks, and he's a little more active now.
I love Banks.
You know what I'm saying? He's a lot more active now, but...
But what he ain't... I already know he not gonna call 50 and be like, you was right, da-da-da.
You know what?
Know.
But this is something that I do believe.
I just know the nigga.
I believe that because Banks gave him the hook for In the Club, I don't believe that he should ever have a money issue for the rest of his life. You know, friend or not, you don't got to like me.
You're talking about 50 Cent, though.
Yeah, no doubt.
But the nigga won't even give his son no money.
I mean, but...
Because it felt like his son violated.
Yeah, no doubt. I
so
feel
if,
you.
If I could cut my son off for a violation, by Banks, basically.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, I know
that's
how
just
50 is.
How he moved. You know what I mean?
I just
like,
feel like...
Then he feel like if... What you talking about to him is called entitlement. He don't appreciate that with nobody.
Yeah, no doubt.
He don't appreciate feeling entitled to nothing with nobody.
Yeah, I know.
So what you talking about is a guilt feeling of entitlement. Like, dang, I owe him for what he did for me. He not going to do that.
I don't even want him to feel like that. But when if Banks wrote the hook to one of the biggest hip-hop records in history, and that song has hit like over 1 billion streams. I just believe that, you know, on a business side, that he should get a publishing check for the rest of his life as long as people...
But 50 is already don't want to do that, for one, and for two, will make up any excuse.
Not to do it.
Not to do
it. Yeah,
exactly.
You know what I'm saying? And, of course, you know, Game will never be back with G-Unit, and I'm glad because I don't like Game. I think he's a great rapper.
I ain't never... Let me shut up.
You know,
I ain't never buy into that.
But Game is definitely a person that can't be trusted on no level.
I ain't never ever
you know
buy into
that. Me personally, right?
Fred Sanford had a word for people like him when I was young.
Everybody,
it wasn't even a word. It was this.
Everybody got their own thing.
Boy,
you know what I'm saying? Flip
floppy, boy.
You know, everybody got stuff they might not want you to know. Everybody has their own way of doing things. But if you make me a millionaire, right, and take me all around the world and I'm able to feed my family and able to go do shows because of an opportunity that you gave me, and we have a fallout. I ain't ever got to rock with you again, but I'm never going to beef with you or talk bad about you. Whatever issue I have with you, if I want to cuss you out, I'll call you and tell you how I feel about you. I ain't never going to publicly denounce you. You changed my life. You know what I'm saying? You changed my life when I was out here selling Nick bags. You put millions of dollars in my pocket. So I'm never going to denounce you publicly. I might not like you. I might call you up and be like, nigga, you were such and such and such and such. But I'm never going to do that publicly.
It would be a much better place if everybody thought like us.
You know what I'm saying? And my reason why is because you know how many people do business with each other that don't like each other? But it's money involved. And it's good money. And he might say, I don't even like this bitch ass nigga. But every time I do something with him, boy, I get a big bag. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, what's going on, dog? You know, you dapping him up. You don't really like him, but this is business. This ain't about us being homies and friends. You know what I'm saying? We ain't never got to be friends. But if we can get 2-3 mil every time we link up, I'm coming to get the bag. You know what I'm saying? And after that, we don't even talk. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, I'm
to
just
be
not
honest,
a big...
that's actually making y'all stronger than what you were
I'm
before
not a,
you
I'm,
was
I'm
getting
not a
the
big
money.
Fan of all of these people who are going public, trying to embarrass people and air their dirty laundry out, and these people change your life. See, that's why when Steve Harvey said, that's why I keep a couple of niggas around me that ain't about nothing but some head busting. Because I'm telling you, man, all it takes is for one person who did that to get fucked up. And people start changing their mindset because everything ain't for everybody to know. You know what I'm saying? If you beat your wife, right, and I know that, and we have an argument, I'm not the person who's going to put that out there. You know what I'm saying? Because we had a fallout. Your own karma going to get you. I ain't going to go, oh, this is why I don't like the nigga. He be beating on his wife. And, you know what I'm saying? Nigga, you put millions of dollars in my pocket.
I always thought that was corny, too, because that's new information, first of all. You only saying that because you mad. You could tell when somebody do that shit and they only saying that shit because they mad. You're like, hold on. You're talking about something he just did.
Yeah, but Game
ain't
always.
Talking about no O's.
He always been a snake, yo. And, you know. And
man, look. It was an incident.
The way I move now,
you remember
like
the incident where he got in trouble for pulling the gun out on the young teenage kid?
Yeah.
You remember that?
Mm-hmm.
That combined with the street people telling me that he not really a gangster, he not really this, his brother was all of that, da-da-da-da.
Mm-hmm.
And then I did my homework, and I did see him on that dating show.
Yeah.
And he had a butterfly tattoo on his face. So when I was doing my homework and everything, I was like, man.
He just somebody that can rap, but he was a snake.
Nah, he's a try-hard. You know, you
what
got.
What up, Yachty Breeze?
Got,
I see you.
You got three different type of people from the hood.
Christina,
you got
what's
the
up,
dude
Chris?
That's actually book smart. You got the dude that's actually gangster. And then you got the try-hard that's trying to be both, whichever one he could be.
What Cat Williams say? You hard at breakfast, nigga? Damn, you hard? Why you eating bacon?
Because he don't know. He just try. See, when you're trying to be something, you don't know how it really is, how it really go. Yeah. You just trying to be it. So one minute I see you trying to be this upstanding person. Then I see you trying to be a thug. Like, come on.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Which one
is it? That's our hip-hop news for the day, man. And don't forget, Sick Mike got the peace rally going down this Saturday.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He do it every year.
Yeah.
Peace rally. Too much drama going on in the hood. Shout out VA Villains. Sick Mike, what's good? Big Dog.
What it
you
is,
know what I'm saying?
Dog.
It is going down 11 a.m. No. Yeah, it starts. They setting up at 11. Noon, they're going to be welcoming people. From 12:30 to 1:25, live DJ and music. They're going to have live performances and everything. This is going to be going down to 5 o'clock. You know what I mean? And it's going down at the King Lincoln Park. 600 Jefferson Avenue, Newport News, Virginia. You know what I'm saying? Downtown. It is the 15th annual Seven Cities Rally for Peace. It's going down Saturday. You know what I'm saying? So y'all want to pull up on Sick Mike, show some love. I know Queen Street Dutch going to be performing, a couple of other people. You know what I'm saying? It's going down. But we're going to get back to the music. Shout out everybody on the live. What's good with y'all? Loose Cannon, I see you. Christina, I see you. Yachty Breeze, what is up, though? Marlon, what's happening, G? Nicole, what's good? L. Burner, Candy Cane, Son of Sam, what's good? Barbara, what's happening? We're about to drop on them, Brooke.
It's that Quran Ali two-tone.
We about to hit y'all with this Quran Ali. We world premiered this last week. It's called Two-Tone. It's on all platforms. Go run it up. Video on YouTube right now. Go run it up. Feed the streets. Let's go.
They double the hate, I double the price. The limit of my crave, I feel it's no measure. Don't fuck with you lames, I'm taking the treasure. I seen it both ways, the homie don't let up. She run to get tamed, tell her don't get up. Too many on play, I'm focused on chillin'. They watching my wave, I'm feeling like bigger. Don't study no hoes and don't fuck with these niggas. They double the hate, I double the pressure. The limit of my crave, feel it's no measure. Don't fuck with you lames, taking the treasure. They seen it both ways, the homie don't let up. She run to get tamed, tell her don't get up. Too many on play,
focus on cheddar, they watching my weight. I'm feeling like bigger, don't study, no hoes and don't fuck with these niggas. Double the pressure to double my money. With us, no bunny, she moving that powder. The niggas be hating the pheasants and cam with the hood that I'm repping. Eat demons and lions, the scheme that you trying ain't working, bro. Seen you a snake, no binoculars. Hell from Metropolis, right when the top on us, plus and no minuses. Getting that mugger, the crew color bugger, she moving that sugar. Focus on D-Day, but homie be jugging, and I know I'm not bugging, but this one is perfect. Bang with a purpose, these fuckers be lost. They still in the sauce and riding my way. Your wife wanna roll for minimum wage. Homie, I'm dangerous with chasing that paper. The streets never love us. Hope heaven the rubbers keep working the cover. And rappers on budget. Hoes wanna creep. I put them to sleep. A rapper on beef. Now you're stranded a week. Don't fuck with no brokes. They living on jokes. My heart is on shelf. The better my living. The whipper concept. Mean it ain't out yet. Who fucking with them? Nigga, you know that they doubt it. Gang. They double the hate, I double the pressure. Deliver my crave, I feel it's no measure. Don't fuck with you lanes, I'm taking the treasure. Seen it both ways, the homie don't let up. She wanna get tame, told her don't get up. Too many don't play, I'm focused on cheddar. They watching my wave, I'm feeling like bigger. Don't study, no hoes and don't fuck with your niggas. They double the hate, I double the pressure. Deliver my crave, I feel it's no measure. Don't fuck with no lanes, taking the treasure. I seen it both ways, the homie don't let up. She wanna get tame, told her don't get up. Too many don't play, I'm focused on cheddar. They watching my wave, I'm feeling like bigger. Don't study, no hoes and don't fuck with these niggas. I double it, they fumble. It. No budget, bitch, no government. Getting a bag, I'm loving it. Getting the haters up off, I'm getting. I doing no struggling. Remember the days of the smuggling. Show the tussling. Pitching on corners from night to the morning. Dream of one of us scoring. So I'm used to the pressure. The haters, no lesser. Baby on go. Told her don't let up. She told me lay back. And just a setup. It seemed I was strapped. I told her I know better to put pussy before the skriller. Get cold, be the chinchilla. When the ends not coming, the biddies not loving homes. I stay with a hustle like Nipsey. Boo for the trenches. I'm gifted from your soul. Get lifting out of your body, homie, don't try me, I'm really on mission. Smoking that Zod to ease all attention. Beat in the booth, the paper through roof. Stay with the baddie, the Cooper Denali. My nigga, I'm shooting the ballies. Yeah, nigga, don't try me. Gang, gang. They double the hate, I double the pressure. Deliver my crave, I feel it's no measure. Don't fuck with you lanes, I'm taking the treasure. I seen it both ways, the homie don't let up. She wanna get tame, told her don't get up. Too many don't play, I'm focused on cheddar. They watching my wave, I'm feeling like bigger. Don't study, no hoes and don't fuck with they niggas. They double the hate, I double the pressure. Deliver my crave, I feel it's no measure. Don't fuck with no lanes, taking the treasure. I seen it both ways, the homie don't let up. She wanna get tame, told her don't get up. Too many don't play, I'm focused on cheddar. They watching my wave, I'm feeling like bigger. Don't study, no hoes and don't fuck with these niggas. Gator. Yo, man. Shout out Powered by Virginia Radio. Feed the streets. Yeah. DMV, what up? Brooklyn, New York. What it do? East Coast, let's go. Yeah. Gator.
Rockin' bandanas, babe. I don't mean no disrespect, but I ain't got no manners. They say this and they be saying that, depend on who you ask. I'ma always turn up all the check. I chase that bitch the fastest. Won't put diamonds all around my neck. Was brown, I got them massive. Had to gamble, had to place my bets. You know we taking chances. You can't help out no one but yourself. These people take advantage. And the trick is working on two digits. I just want a ticket. Driving fast, I'm on the interstate. You know I deliver. All up around my neck like I'm reducing swelling. Rap sheet still super long, like fuck these raps, I'm with the feelings. I'm always turn up out a check. I chase that bitch the fastest. I got deals for a lower price depending on who asking. Catching plays out here every night. I feel like John Madden. Niggas fake, see it in they eyes. They faker than some lashes. Stacking down, I'm like, bro, what's up? Tell me who I'm smashing. Instant replay, we spin back to back whenever it be asked. All there was love. Niggas turned they back and then they ran and bashed. All it was love. You know dust to dust. You know ash to ash. Out of town, running through the money. I feel like a scammer. I got niggas on my right and left. They both rocking bandanas, babe. I don't mean no disrespect, but I ain't got no manners. They say this and they be saying that. Depend on who you ask. I'ma always turn up all the check. I chase that bitch the fastest. Won't put diamonds all around my neck. Chris Brown, I got him dancing. Had to gamble. Chances, you can't help out no one but yourself. These people take advantage, smoking loud. You can't turn it down. This shit right here.
shot these people too demanding. Put designer all around my belt and still got my pants sagging. Out of town with my clip extended, standing on the business. Where I'm from, I'm a big gangster, feel like Jimmy Henchman. One on one, ain't too many like me. Most these niggas different. I'm just out here trying to chase the dream. 12 trying to pinch me.
Indeed, you know what I'm saying? Y'all already know what it is, man. We hit y'all with that Karan Ali two-tone. Then we hit you with back-to-back exclusives, that Gator, Double the Hate. And then we hit you with that Jelani. That joint was called Scammer. Scammer. You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And you know, everybody know what's going on with the councilman. You know, everybody been on his top because, you know, basically he tried to get some dome. He was getting some dome from a chick. She found out who he was. Then she tried to shut him up. And, you know, he tried to give her a couple stacks. Like, look, man, just stop, man. You're doing too much. But, you know, they done went all crazy with it. So everybody was calling for him to step down. And he announced today that, you know, hey, you know, I do apologize. And I'm sorry, you know, and I'm going to get right with God, but I ain't stepping down. You know what I'm saying? Like I don't care what y'all talking about. You know, at the end of the day, he's been crucified because he wanted to get some dome. You know what I'm saying?
Man, fight for your rights.
And, you know, I interviewed him when we was doing the City on My Chest event, and then he came up to Fertitta's when we was doing the Christmas joint we was giving back. And you know, me and him chopped it up outside for a few minutes. You know what I mean? He was like, man, you everywhere, ain't you? Because he had seen me earlier at the high school that day helping them with the back-to-school Christmas, I mean, the Christmas giveaway, too. So he was like, man, you just everywhere, you know what I mean? So we were just outside chopping it up, you know. His personal business ain't really none of my business, but at the end of the day, he basically had a shorty that was, you know, sucking them off or whatever, you know.
It don't sound familiar?
Yeah.
A little Bill Clinton.
Yeah, you know, except in this case, you know, before it went public, you know, he told her, look, man, take this money, man. How you doing too? She set him up because once she found out who he was in the position that he had, she knew that.
But Bill kept his job, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's so, all I'm going to say.
And,
there you go.
So Councilman Bowman said, yo, I ain't stepping down.
Did Bill step down?
He said, I don't care nothing about what you're talking about, you know, hey. Plenty of people do it. She just set me up. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day. You know what I mean?
Guess she ain't want to no more.
All artists, you know, if you want to sing your music, you got to send your music to Feed the Streets. That's Feed the, T-H-A, Feed the Streets Radio at gmail.com. You got to make sure that it's MP3. Don't send more than 3 songs. And you got to put the song title, the artist name, and your social media tag so we know how to shout you out. You know what I'm saying? And don't forget to follow that Feed the Streets Radio Facebook page and that Feed the Streets Radio IG page. What's up, Brooklyn Joker? What we got for him, G?
We got that Makes Sense coming up next.
Okay, we about to hit y'all with that Unique Hustle Hard. You know what I mean? Makes Sense. Make it make sense. You already know when you heard it first. Feed the Streets Radio, you dig? Shout out everybody on the live. What's good, man? Say yo if you're rocking with us right now, you dig?
Street. They can really show you how to modify. They can rearrange their whole arm aside. They don't know about the Cobra Kai. They don't know where the spirit lies. That afterlife, I'm gonna call it mine. Been sliding all type of nights until the day I see the light. This life is going way too fast. You don't want to know about my past. All I know, I'm just here to last. Why they get so mad? Cause my whip's older than the Dreamcast. And them horses running like it's meant to last. With a bad chick in the driver's seat. Tatted up with the Louis belt. Fresh bitch, she about her health. She knows she bad. Walking with the chrome pad, taking pictures like it's yesterday, cause every day is like a birthday. She can pull up cause she know where I be. Sounds booming coming up the street. Motor screaming like it's off the leash.
I got the dough, I got the juice, I got the clothes, I got the shoes, but I need some more. I need some more. I need some more. I need some more. I got the whip, I got the drip, I got a thing, boy, and I keep it on my head.
I need some more. in my whip. Damn. I be doing what I wanna. Only smoking marijuana, boy, you don't wanna. Fuck it with us, or you a gonna hit a nigga with the 40, boy, you know I'm on.
Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit.
Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Fuck you and who your team is. Y'all ain't never gonna be shit. Didn't know you had a happy home. Didn't mean to come between it, but your baby mama said she needed it, so I just came to give her penis. Ah, now I gotta go outside, rope around the bitch to pull her off of my dick. You won't find a remedy for none of these lyrics, nigga, face it, I'm sick.
I'm sick.
Tonight, I'ma kick up with a squad, probably doing some unusual shit.
Like what?
Like Spock, Zipaline, then I pop a lot of Molly, still I'm rapping like this.
Goddamn, goddamn, goddamn.
I'm going Warthog, why these niggas go ham? Fully automatic, even on a slow jam. I'ma take it, ain't nobody let you know who I am. Well, let me introduce myself. I'm Smoke, the immortal, don't say I didn't warn you. When I pull up at your crib, put some bullets in your ribs, and the fam can't warn you, cause they about to join you.
Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit. Got you niggas fucking fiending for this fucking SOG shit.
Little bitch. Motherfucker, one hell of a clown, nigga.
Yeah, yeah.
Squad.
Whoa.
Easy.
Yeah, that was that Loose Cannon featuring Smoke the Immortal PZ180. Free PZ, that joint called Fiendin'. You know what I'm saying? We world premiered that joint last week, too. You know what I mean? They went real hard on that joint. Before that, we hit y'all with that Unique Hustle Hard, Make It Make Sense. You ain't getting to the moolah. You ain't making no sense.
We had a couple joints we wanted to play, but they're not MP3, so they're not playing. It's coming up as an error.
Yeah, we had a, what up, Rosie? I see you. What up, Smoke? What's good, G?
It was an R&B joint.
Smoke the Immortal on the Live.
What was the name of the song?
It was a couple of records we were supposed to play. Angel, Monique, On and On, R&B record. You got to resend that to me. It's not...
It's reading error.
Yeah, it's reading error. You know what I'm saying? When we try to play it. So it's not registering with the system. So sometimes if you like send it from like an iPhone or something like that, it don't register with the system. That's, you know what I'm saying? You got to send it MP3. But we will get it on if you resend that joint, man.
And it was another one.
And the Mini 00 My Time joint... is also reading error.
Resend
those. Yeah, you know, just resend them, but make sure it's MP3. We always say MP3 is because that's what the system that we work with plays is MP3s, you know what I'm saying? That's why we always be like, don't send no links, no none of that,
no,
you know what I'm saying?
Files,
no WAV files, none of that, you know what I'm saying? It's got to be MP3, you know what I mean?
Got a treat for y'all.
So, you know, y'all know every Thursday we hit y'all with, you know, an old school joint today. Shout out Real Spill. What's
Real
good,
Spill, what's good,
I
my
see
brother.
You, homie. You know
I
what I mean?
I see you, dog.
Everybody on the line, you know, every week we always hit y'all with a throwback joint. And this week, you know, we got a treat, you know, this happens to be Brooklyn Joker's favorite rapper, you know what I'm saying? And he definitely made his impact in hip-hop. He was the first person known as the Punchline King. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
He was the first artist to win the Mixtape Artist of the Year Award and then turned around and had the number one album in the country. That's pretty impressive.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying? And
the dude's so cool that he don't even like attention. How you an artist that don't like attention?
Yeah, yeah. You know, he represent
the streets.
That unit flag, you know what I'm saying? That
all my G unit heads, man. I got a treat for y'all, man. Y'all remember these
days,
right?
You know what I'm saying? So we gonna take y'all back. Lloyd Banks, aka Blue Hefner, aka Gang Green. You know what I'm saying? Throwback joint of the day. Feed the Streets Radio. Powered by Virginia. Let's go.
Come on.
Hey, look, man. When G-Unit was running shit for real, the niggas, they was running shit.
You know what I'm saying? Listen what I'm trying to tell you, man.
I can't take nothing from them. When they had it on Smash, they had it on
Can I keep it 100 with y'all for a second? Because the first G-Unit that really had that street shit popping was Mobb Deep, right? Mm-hmm. But Mobb Deep extended not as far as G-Unit did. It's like G-Unit took the same shit and went global with that.
See, the way they did it was different too. Because once Eminem signed 50, the whole world put eyes on 50. See what I'm saying? And 50's album was so big, and by him having them with him,
I'm gonna help you out, but I'm gonna say my part too, because you're correct. You are correct.
Yeah.
But before M even, I'm going to tell you why M came and got him and signed him.
Because
of what I'm talking about.
Because he had the streets on Smash.
Because of what I'm telling you, my nigga. It wasn't just New York no more.
It expanded.
Mobb Deep did it, but it was just New York.
You know what I'm saying?
When G-Unit did it.
They did, but they did it only in New York.
Yes, they did. They was the first.
What's the name of them albums?
What you mean? The mixtapes that they put out? It's mad in them shits. You want me to pull them up?
They don't got them.
Yes, it is. It's mad in. Yo, them niggas got mad goddamn mixtapes. What you trying to say? Hold on. All of them albums, is they real albums? That's what you saying?
Well, they albums, yeah, but the mixtapes.
They got. I could pull up ten Mobb Deep albums right now.
G-Unit took a different route with the mixtapes. They wasn't putting out like they real songs.
I'm trying to tell you that even 50 gave them the props, yo.
Yeah.
Even 50 signed them later because he said, yo, I took y'all idea and branded it globally.
What I tried to do with B-Mob, when we was dropping the mixtapes and we was rapping over the beats, you know what I'm saying?
Same time, same shit. We was all trying to do that shit. This nigga had at least goddamn 7 rappers he could pull up on you right now.
You know what
now.
I'm saying? I remember when he was doing the same thing. When I put out a mixtape for the first time, I didn't even have a DJ hosting it.
All I'm saying is, what's the name of
the
mixtape?
It's mad of them shits, bro. I'm about to pull them up. It's mad of them. Hold on.
I mean, you know, 50 took it. 50 and them took it. They took it to a different level. You know what I'm saying?
I'm going to tell you why. The business why.
Yeah.
Streetwise, only thing Mobb Deep had to move through was the DJ connects they had.
Yeah.
Which was like Craig, SNS, Craig G, all the DJs, Ron G, and all that. So they was able to make that move first.
Yeah, and 50 story sold, you know.
But the days and times change also as well. Yeah. It ain't just all 50 benefit that he did that, but the days and times came to where the air got out. And hoods everywhere want to hear that hood shit.
Yeah. I mean, G-Unit had the most impressive mixtape run ever.
They don't bang Jay-Z in the UK. They bang 50 Cent.
Yeah, 50 was the first, G-Unit was the first group to get a plaque off a mixtape.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Like, they took it to a new level. They made it where niggas wanted to drop mixtapes.
They couldn't get a deal, so they took the mixtape.
You know what I'm saying?
I love the fact that 50, when he succeeded in the mission, went back and got them and told them straight up, bro, I got this whole movement idea from y'all, bro. He got the whole G-Unit movement, gangster movement idea from them. He said it. He said, yo, the way y'all was moving, I like that.
Well, you know, I heard stories about Mobb Deep, though. Just from watching, like, a lot of the Drink Champs and stuff like that, people say that before they popped off, that, like, it used to be like 100 of them niggas running around the city with CDs. And you know what I'm saying? And they always was beefing with niggas. And You know what I'm saying? You know,
it was like that with Old Dirty Bastard. Even though he was a Wu-Tang Clan member, he ran with a different group. He had a whole 100 niggas with him that wasn't, you know what I mean? They was Wu-Tang, but they was claiming it because they
with
him.
Yeah, with the Old Dirty and shit. You know, Lloyd Banks, man, didn't have a career he should have had, but he, his first album was a classic. You know what I'm saying? His second album wasn't the real album that we were supposed to get, Rotten Apple, but, you know, it still went gold. And then, you know, he dropped Hunger for More 2 independently, and that did crazy numbers independently. Him and Jules Santana, Beamer, Benz, and Bentley single went gold. You know what I'm saying? He got a double platinum album, couple of gold singles, you know what I'm saying? You know, the first G-Unit album did something like 4 times platinum. So, you know, Banks had an impressive mixtape run as well. You know what I'm saying? He got a couple of mixtape that go in the classic side. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, that was the throwback joint of the day, man.
Life of the Infamous is one of the jumps.
Shout out everybody on the live, man.
The safest crack. Y'all
know
is one of the
we
joints.
Do this every Thursday.
Juvenile
at 8 p.m. You know what I'm saying?
No, they got three. And, they got three before that though. That was mixtape.
If you're an artist and you're trying to get your song on, you know what I'm
the
saying?
Infamous, send it
to
Murder
Feed
Music,
the Streets Radio.
Infamy,
that's Feed the THA.
America's Nightmare, Blood Money. And
make
Infamous.
Sure it's MP3.
All right, it's three mixtapes before they even put the
put
album
your
out.
Song title, artist title, social media tags. You know what I'm saying? And don't send more than 3 songs. And, you know, if all of the songs rock, we'll play all of them, but not on the same night. You know what I'm saying? And
Life for the Infamous.
You got any shout-outs, Brooklyn Joker?
Man, you know me, man. Same old thing. Shout-out to Ty-Nika, the whole Power by Virginia family. Shout-out to everybody listening. You know what it is. And that's it, man. I really know.
Yeah, I just want to shout-out everybody that rock with us every week.
If I'm shouting anybody out, it's y'all, man. The people that's rocking with us, that's who I'm shouting out, man.
Everybody on the live right now, you know what I'm saying? T-Dub, we played your joint, T-Dub, you know what I'm saying? I need some more. He definitely making moves with that, man. And y'all know what we do. Spit and Spar.
Shout out to Real
7th.
Spill.
It's going down. You trying to get down? Holla at Loud. Yachty Breeze said she coming to win the 3rd one in a row and get the championship belt. Is there somebody who can stop that? Where's the hottest rappers in the city with these crazy records? Spit and Spar. October 7th is going down. Hey, yo, remember the movie with Spike Lee, Do the Right Thing? Mm-hmm. And it had the dude who used to stutter. Mm-hmm. He'd be like, Malcolm.
He mad old now. That's the dude, you believe it or not, that's the dude that's in all the goddamn movies now.
Yeah. He is in a lot. Hey, yo. But the funniest stuttering nigga was in Harlem Nights, yo. The world champ boxer nigga.
Somebody gonna get
knocked out.
Fuck out.
You know what I'm saying? He said, I do now. Remember what that nigga said? Hey, sign his autograph for me.
He's stupid. Yeah.
He said, don't sign autographs. He said, oh, you gonna sign it or your ass going to jail too. That nigga couldn't call a taxi for nothing, yo. Hey, yo.
I'm gonna call it a taxi.
Finish him over that shit.
Oh, man. That's crazy, man. The whole world. But yeah, man, we be here same time next Thursday, 8 p.m. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you tap in and don't forget it's going down this Sunday at Aberdeen Elementary School. They're going to be giving away free gun locks. They're going to be teaching you how to use your gun lock. They're giving away some free bulletproof book bags. They also are giving away 100 stuffed book bags with school supplies in it for the kids. It's going free ice cream. It's going down from 1 to 5 this Sunday at Aberdeen Middle School. You know what I'm saying? Come get you a free gun lock, man. They're giving out gun safes and all that. And Saturday, the 15th annual Peace Rally, Sick Mike VA Villains, that's going down at Kane Lincoln Park. You know what I'm saying? I don't know all the artists performing, but I know Queen Street Dutch is going to be put on out there. Come out there, support that thing. You know what I'm talking about? And as Quavo would say, we gone. I see y'all next Thursday. We out.